gotta be reading my mind. So.
She used to work for the housing authority too.
Does anybody in the house not work for the housing authority?
Well, I'm gonna have them all stay at late.
I'm trying to be short about this. Yes, working with Johnson C. Smith, working with the city on what's called a choice neighborhood planning grant. Okay, to work with what Johnson C. Smith has already done in the master plan to redevelop that entire area. But we need to get money from HUD. I think it's gonna be somewhere between $250,000 to $500,000 to do the planning grant to then go after the implementation grant. So that's a yes on working with Johnson C. Smith, the city, the housing authority. I've even talked to Center City Partners. There's a list of the police, there's a list of 10 or 15 people that we're working on to try to get that application in by May, just so you know.
What would happen to the residents there now?
In every situation, residents will be a part of the deal. It's gonna be very difficult for me, and this is, and I don't get beat up in the press and everything, that's okay. It's very difficult for me to talk about doing development and working with individuals that have lived there through all of the bad times. And then we're talking about putting them somewhere out of sight, out of mind in the deal. That won't happen with me. They're gonna be somewhere located within that property. They're gonna be an integral part of the property, because guess what? You couldn't get the choice neighborhood grant without it. You couldn't get the implementation grant without the residents that are living there in public housing. These are directly related to the fact that, you have a public housing area there. So they need to be taken care of. They will have supportive services. They will be made sure that that they are moving in the direction of self-sufficiency when they come back. Yes, but they will be, those residents will be a part of this deal. They won't be just exiled someplace. What I'm doing and what my staff is going to be directed to do is what I'm doing today. I think the more that we're able to see the people that we're talking about, the less we'll have those perceptions. The more we're able to see those. I'm going to be trying to pull some of my successful residents into the picture so people can kind of see that we're talking about each other. In this matter, working with you, and you do a great job at what you do in McCreesh, I'm saying that we have to be bolder about sharing with the public what we actually do, okay? And I don't want to say this, okay? Putting on Front Street those individuals that are the bigots and the racists and don't want those individuals living there. I think that's the only way to do it. I think that if we don't, as loud, I'm sorry, just a minute. As loud as they are, we gotta be louder, okay. I'm thinking there are some communities that is happening with right now. I think it's in, is it Peace? Southside is one of those locations, so yes. An extremely high level of commitment to make sure that our kids are taken care of. The issue, though, is how do we fund it? And that means that, you know, I'll put it up front. I'm going to have a better relationship and with the school system and the programs that are already being provided. I got to make sure that my residents are going to be there, because I may not be able to afford to have a full-blown educational program in every single community, because again, that's not our core business that we do. I think it's something that helps our core business, but it's not what we do. So partnering with CMS and working with them on things like getting permission slips so that some of our case managers can have the information on how the kids are doing in school, so that we can kind of wrap that into our overall service plan with our parents, and asking parents to participate in PTA meetings and et cetera. Those are the kind of things that we want to do. But the funding of it is the biggest issue. One of the things, and I don't want to say, because it hasn't been fully discussed, so I'm going to talk about it in a broad sense. Bridging the digital divide is something in which we're talking with other partners about how do we, in some way, have computers and bringing broadband to our residents. Because if, you know, you have, if anybody in the room has children right now, you know, my kid does a lot of work on iPads and computers right now, okay? And so computers are just like, almost like having a telephone to a great extent. And so we're working on that now with some partners to see how we can bring that to our communities.